Hey, in this video, we'll be looking at how to get data from any API inside Rows. For the purposes of this demo, we'll be looking at Weather API as an example. And with that, let's get started. In the input table, really all we need is the name of the city. So I'm going to mark that here, make it bold. I'm going to add an input field inside cell B1 so we can enter the name of that city. For now, I'm going to use Berlin as an example. We can also remove any additional rows or columns that we wouldn't really end up using in the live mode. As for the config table, the first thing we'd need is the API endpoint. We can then go to the documentation and look for it, which is sitting right here. I'm going to go ahead and copy the entire endpoint right there and paste it right inside the cell. You'd notice that we'd need to modify this queue parameter, which is currently hard-coded to London. So I'm going to cut it and paste that information at the very end. I'm going to go ahead and delete London from here and then cut the entire endpoint for now. Use our concat function to paste the first string to be the input from the previous step and string 2 to reference the input cell sitting in B1. Once we have that, the next thing really all we need to do is make the get request. For that, you can just do equals get. And you'd notice that it asks us for an action URL, which is really the only mandatory parameter. And I'm going to reference that to cell B1 right here. Once you have the output, you can click on the list icon there, explore the JSON. What we really need is sitting inside the forecast object right here. You'll see that there is an R object available here, which has 24 data points. And this is really what we'll be consuming, the time and the temperature in centigrade. I'm going to go ahead and copy this R object and paste that information here. So I'm going to name that R leaf forecast. Once we have that, we can then create a new table. I'm going to name that log and go back and open our R leaf forecast object once again, just to see what data points do we actually need. So in this case, we need the time as well as the temp underscore C parameters. So these are the two parameters that we'd actually need. And so what I'm going to do next is I'm going to use our overwrite function, take the data sitting in B3 and push that into our log table from the ranges A1 to B1. Once you hit enter, you'll see the log table being updated automatically. I'm going to name that add to log. Once you've reached this far, really the final step is to just select the entire range, go to the create chart option right here. We can also make sure that these bounds are open, which is to say that should there be more data points, the chart would accordingly be updated. I'm going to go ahead and rename this chart as the report. We can also move this report a little closer to our input. That way it looks nicer when we publish this in the live mode. I'm going to go ahead and close the chart editor now. And when sharing this with the rest of the world, we may not want the config table to be visible to everyone. So we can go ahead and toggle that to be hidden from this option right here. Once you're good, go ahead and click on the share option, choose to publish it to the world, copy the link, open an incognito window, and then load the app right here. We can also test this by entering a different city. For example, I'm going to try Porto, hit enter, and then you'll see the data being updated automatically. I hope this video helped, and thanks for watching.